warriors, two teams, two gatekeepers, one throne. The 10th season of the Gulda Ultimate Search presents the search for the 10th symbol. Two gatekeepers must return and lead 12 brave warriors back into the treacherous Usaka jungle. In teams of 6 warriors each, the brave warriors must battle against each other and the wild elements of the jungle. Only the victorious team will advance, and only one must return with the 10th symbol. Get ready for this epic adventure. Gulda, the ultimate. Drink responsibly. Today in the jungle, our warriors are up before the dawn. Perhaps they have a feeling about what is coming on. Yesterday they ate goat, but got too greedy. This morning, they receive a visit from an angry chibi.
Up. Get up.
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 Wake up.
Warriors, up.
Up. Get up. Everybody out here in 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. Who's still there?
No one's there.
Check it out. Get down. 20 push-ups. Let's go. Quickly. Push-ups again, let's go. Move it.
Chidi is clearly not in a good mood.
Quick. Yeah, thanks for doing 10 push-ups. Finish it, let's go. Let's go. Now shake it out. Shake out all that sleep. Shake it out. Jump. Let's go. 1, 2, let's go. Move it. Good, relax. Good. What happened in this camp yesterday?
Nothing much, sir. We just had our feast with the goat and we all slept.
How did that happen?
You mandated that he should kill the goat and prepare it for us. Mm-hmm.
Who prepared the goat?
He did.
He did?
Yes, sir.
So you lied?
Yes.
You flouted direct instructions. You had direct orders. Kill the goat, prepare the goat, serve the tribe. That was the orders yesterday. The order was not communal preparation of the goat.
No,
the order was not put hands together and prepare the goat. The other was not decide together what to do with the goat. No, that was not the other.
Goat is a large animal, right? And while he was cutting it, there are areas where he needed someone to hold a piece for him so he could cut. And one or two other occasions, we actually helped him hold the piece of meat for him to cut. And that was it.
Consequences for every action that you do not take properly.
Yes, sir.
Give me another 20 of you.
I didn't lie, per se.
I killed the goat myself. I cut it open. And when it got to time to remove the intestine and maybe the stomach, I didn't know how to. The gallbladder, so it wouldn't make the meat bitter. So Eddie helped me.
We just wanted the process to be quick so we could have something to eat. And that was why we disobeyed Chidi.
As leader, do you like it when they fire your order? Did you give any orders yesterday?
I did, yes, sir.
To who?
To him while he was trying to.
What order did you give him?
To make sure he kills the girl and prepares it alone, sir.
And?
He did, sir.
No, he did not. Because we see everything. We know everything. We hear everything. And you know that. And this is the first and last time a direct order from the council will be flouted. You lose your position as leader for the next 48 hours, you will not have anything to eat. I hope you had enough of that Harry yesterday. Right? The tribe is yours now. Learn a lesson. See you all there.
Thank you, sir.
There's something I like about me. I always know how to break records. I know how to set records that I've not been heard of before. I mean, being the record holder for shortest time of being the leader of a tribe, not too awesome, but hey, I'm just human.
I've learned that no matter how nice you are, you cannot please everyone. And once they give instructions, you must follow it to the last letter, to the last punctuation mark. You must follow it strict instructions.
After Chidi has finished trashing the tent, the tribe recovers under the interim leadership of Ifunaya, yesterday's second place finisher.
Consequence, names of capitals in the world, I start by saying Abuja.
Cairo.
Mekimiko.
What do you say? What do you say now?
Mekimiko.
Mamimiko. Mamimiko. Mamimiko.
Mamimiko.
Mamimiko. I will slap this one.
To lighten the mood a bit, they practice their non-verbal communication with every warrior's favorite game, charades.
Is it a military dress?
Strauss. Okay. Let's say it's S.
Suede jeans.
Suede denim.
Suede trousers.
Akoche. Suede.
63.
Swedish.
64. 65. 66.
Just in case.
67.
Suede leather.
69. Cripple. 71.
Athletes.
72. 73.
Military.
74.
Military.
But you see, they
camouflage.
I don't count 74.
Camouflage.
You see,
74. Oh! Squadron leader. Hey, got squadron.
Some people have asked if we aren't tired of making the point that Gulda beer is made from premium barley, the finest hops, the purest of waters, and extra mature to perfection through the ultimate brewing process by the ultimate brew masters for the ultimate man. When you get tired of hearing your own name, then we'll change our story. Gouda, the ultimate.
Welcome back to the Gouda Ultimate Search 10. We are still on the quest for the 10th symbol. Remember, we are on the third phase of our quest. This is the phase where every challenge really does count and every mistake can be very costly. In life, our ability to twist, bend, and wriggle our way through all of the hardships and obstacles thrown at us is a necessary quality of survival. And today, we will be testing for flexibility. Enjoy. The insubordination from yesterday, leading up to this morning's events, was really unnecessary and uncalled for. The Council of Elders gave you permission to make merry, enjoy yourselves, and party in the jungle. But there was a proviso. There was a consequence that was dealt to one of your members. The instructions were clear and concise. You broke the rules. Dennis,
sir.
Yesterday, out of the blues, your god came out of vacation and handed you first leadership of the tribe.
Yes, sir.
And less than 24 hours later, your god is back on vacation because you totally lost everything. As a matter of fact, now you have the record for probably the shortest leadership run in history. Do I look like I'm laughing?
Scoffing, sir.
So what's funny?
Scoffing.
What do you have to say for yourself?
Sir, yesterday's incident, I can just say I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry.
I guess now you have better appreciation for what Tony must have been going through as a leader.
I do.
Is that what you meant when you say he didn't listen to everybody? Leadership must be firm. You don't have to take what everybody says. You cannot please everybody at the same time. Edmund,
yes, sir.
I thought you understood this better. You had a leadership run that I thought was a model for good leadership. But it seems to me that you can make a very good and disciplined leader, but a rebellious follower. What happened?
We just knew he couldn't. He was the one in charge of doing everything. He killed the goat himself. He started skinning himself, but it got to a point where he needed help. So we thought we could just help him, and then he would cook it on his own. He found the firewood alone, and he served us. So I didn't see it as being that way too.
The instructions were specific. They did not hear the instructions.
I'm sorry,
the instruction I'm sorry, was for him to kill, cook, prepare, and serve. It was specific. Yes, there was no ambiguity about it.
I'm sorry, sir.
You have brought this all upon yourselves. Hufner.
Sir.
Leadership has come to you. Leadership under pressure. How are you feeling?
Good.
Good? That's what I want to hear. And I hope that you learned some valuable lessons this morning.
Yes, sir.
Good. Anyways, welcome to today's challenge.
Thank you, sir.
Today's challenge is about flexibility. Successful warriors are able to plan. They're able to strategize. But the most successful warriors are able to plan to unplan. You're able to prepare to unprepare. So in life, even when you have made your plans, you will run into obstacles. Your ability to twist, bend, and wriggle your way through the obstacles will decide if you will be successful or not. So today, take a look here. You can see?
Yes, sir.
Eight obstacle courses for the eight of you. At the beginning of this obstacle course, there's a rope. Each of you will attach the rope to yourselves. When I say go, you will make your way through the obstacle course. However you want to do it, wriggle, bend, twist, however. But be careful not to twist the twisted. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Good. When you have made your way to the end of the obstacle, there'll be a riddle waiting for you. You retrieve the riddle and make your way back to your workstation. At your workstation, there are puzzle tiles with which you can solve the riddle. So when you retrieve the riddle, you go back to your workstation, you read it, understand it, find the solution, and use the puzzle tiles to form the answer. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. As usual, there'll be rewards and there'll be consequences. The one who does this in the fastest time will be the winner of this challenge. This will be a timed challenge. You have 30 minutes to run through this course. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Good. Take your game positions.
My name is James Adebayo. My work is my life. And I couldn't do my job without my L200. Experience the L200 only at CFAO Motors.
Mitsubishi L200. Tame your world.
This year, to celebrate the 10th anniversary of the Gulda Ultimate Search, Gulda is inviting fans of the show to a search of their own. The Gulda Ultimate Search presents Fans Edition. All you need is your phone. The treasure is the key to a brand new Mitsubishi Pajero. To be a contestant, buy a bottle of Gulda, send your code to 20388, answer the questions, and watch the Gulda Ultimate Search for clues. There are lots of prizes to be won. So start texting and start searching now. In partnership with Mitsubishi from CFAO Motors, Gulda, the ultimate. Drink responsibly.
Ready, warriors?
Yes, sir.
On my count, 3, 2, go.
The warriors get off to a quick start in the snake maze, twisting and weaving their ways in, out, under, over, and between the obstacles.
Martha seems to have gotten her rope tangled.
So can I start again?
Bring the ring back to first position.
Yes, indeed. She's tangled and has decided to go back to the start.
Kunle and Edmund prove their flexibility. They are the first two to get through and fetch the riddle. Now they have to go back the way they came.
We always knew Anthony was a swift snake in another life. Bobby seems to be too tall for this challenge. He's way, way behind, but not as far behind as Martha. Wait a minute. Martha has unclipped herself again and is clearly cheating.
Now she's been a real snake in the grass. Everyone else slithers through with some success. All except Martha. Martha seems to be watching to see if anyone is watching her. Planning to cheat again? Bad form. Most of our warriors are near the end of the obstacle. They will open the riddle any moment. Some people have asked if we aren't tired of making the point that Gulda beer is made from premium barley. The finest hops. The purest of waters. Extra mature to perfection through the ultimate brewing process by the ultimate brew masters for the ultimate man. When you get tired of hearing your own name, then we'll change our story. Gouda, the ultimate. Dennis has caught up to Edmund. Despite his punishment, he's done a good job on the maze. In the blacksmith's diary, he found a warrior's code. If deciphered, it reveals one of his base tools. Alpha, November, Victor, Indigo, Lima.
Friends!
Edmund has already got a solution. Anvil.
Go ahead.
The riddle is written in military code. A-N-V-I-L. Anvil.
Phase 4. Yes? Correct.
Stop.
Phrase!
Dennis, that's wrong. Not how you spell villain.
Sir, please.
Phrase! Face that way.
And that's still not how you spell it.
Wrong. Freeze!
If at first you don't succeed, try the exact same thing again? Really, Dennis.
Wrong.
Come on, Martha. It's easy. Just cheat again. We were just kidding about cheating, Martha.
Sir?
Friends?
Sir?
Tracy and Ifunaya finish at the same time. A double-headed snake.
Correct.
Sir?
Correct.
Dennis still has the right letters, but can't seem to put them in the right order. Maybe this morning's punishment is distracting him.
Correct?
Martha detaches herself legally this time and finally makes the halfway mark after five warriors have already finished the entire challenge. Anthony has no clue. Dennis now spells alive. Well, that is a nice word.
Friends.
Meanwhile, Martha relishes the moment of rest.
Wrong.
Finally, Dennis. Phew.
What? Correct.
Anthony is becoming more and more clueless. He doesn't even know which way the letters go anymore. Martha, meanwhile, is becoming more tangled. And time is up.
Anthony, your strength and your speed have done nothing for you here. Both of you, you're slow, you're stiff, you're stubborn, and you are not paying attention. You have your mind made up on one track, and that's it. One track and one track alone. Today's challenge is about flexibility, ability to twist, turn, and wriggle your way through whatever the challenges are. Both of you have shown that you are not ready yet. You are both hereby evicted from the ultimate search. Remove your armbands, hand them over to me, return to base camp, pack your things, and leave the jungle now. Amen. Go now.
I wish I had the opportunity to stay a little bit longer. And this morning when I woke up, my leg was spinning, and the whole stuff has to do with your legs and your hand. I'm not disappointed because I tried my best, and I'm sure I'll be able to solve the puzzle, but I didn't just reach there.
Came as a shock, actually. Came as a shock, but well, that's the GUS for the Google Ultimate Search. You have to expect the unexpected, so it happens. I have that endurance, but the ability to really calm down and then reason is quite a bit difficult for me, and we've been without food for how long, so everyone is different. My system is different, that's me. It's not the first puzzle or riddles we've had, and other ones, if I could do well, you know, come out even almost tops, then they should, you know, read in between lines. But well, the deed is done. It's one of those things, so I'm taking it in good faith, actually.
This year, to celebrate the 10th anniversary of the Gulda Ultimate Search, Gulda is inviting fans of the show to a search of their own. The Gulda Ultimate Search presents Fans Edition. All you need is your phone. The treasure is the key to a brand new Mitsubishi Pajero. To be a contestant, buy a bottle of Gulda. Send your code to 20388. Answer the questions and watch the Gulda Ultimate Search for clues. There are lots of prizes to be won. So start texting and start searching now. In partnership with Mitsubishi from CFAO Motors, Gulda, the ultimate. Drink responsibly.
To whom much is given, much is expected. For 10 years, the Council of Elders have tried to find the 10th symbol. And now we are so close. We cannot afford warriors who don't know what military terms are. We cannot afford warriors who cannot twist their way around hurdles and hard situations. No, that is unacceptable. We don't have time to waste. Look at this. The sun rises and sets on us on one challenge. Come on, the villains are doing better than this. We cannot afford that. I hope you all learned a lesson now. This is the Hammer Tribe. This is where you want it to be. But it comes with a lot of responsibility. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. Edmund,
yes, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations for redeeming yourself today.
Thank you, sir.
I hope that the events of this morning do not repeat itself.
No, sir.
You have been a leader before. We liked your leadership. But a good leader is nothing if you cannot follow. And you did not follow properly. Now leadership has come back to you. I have faith in you.
Thank you, sir.
Good. The rest of you, I hope you have learned lessons.
Yes, sir.
This is the third phase. Expect the unexpected. And we must find the tenth symbol.
Yes, sir.
Return to base camp.
Thank you, sir.
I didn't think I heard well until I looked around and I saw him saying both of you were evicted, and it was really shocking. But it happens, we expect surprises.
Two people being evicted at the same time, seriously, I didn't see it coming. That was the shocker of this year's GUS.
And there you have it. They say proper planning prevents poor performance. But I say, proper planning without planning to unplan your plan, without preparing to unprepare your preparedness when life throws you all those challenges is nothing. Those who succeed are those who plan and plan to unplan when everything does not go according to plan. That is flexibility. The intrigue continues. Expect the unexpected. My name is Chidi Mokeme. See you next time.
Akwa Ibom State, considered the most peaceful state in the Niger Delta region, is sandwiched between Abia State and Cross River State and enjoys a fair share of the Atlantic Ocean. Uyo is the state capital of Akwa Ibom State, and interestingly, virtually every section of the state can be easily reached within an hour's drive from the state capital. Every inch of this remarkable state has a story to tell, from the people to the food to the hospitality. But what truly attracts tourism from far and wide is its array of impressive landmarks that dot the state. First on the list is Ibom Tropicana. Then there's the Ibom Plaza, the waterfront, the Mary Slessor's Memorial Cairn, the Bridge of No Return, the first Kwa Ibo Church, and many others. Akwa Ibom State, truly an impressive state. No wonder it's got the world talking.
Since I was the first to finish and I became the leader of Hammer Tribe, I think I'll handle it as I've always handled my leadership positions, apart from following strict and keeping to strict instructions. And thank God there's none today. I'll just be a good follower.
Open that basket, man.
Anything
else? Nothing. Ah, yeah.
The best news. Best news? We are to paint again. Boys, so yeah, let's go have our
bath. I just hope I'm not second to the last anymore. Probably top to the last in any task now. Because it could come at any time. Expect the unexpected. Go out to message.
You can't tell me I don't have eyes, Abby.
I feel good that competition is less. I actually feel good that I was not the one. And I was not the one. So it's a good feeling.
Nothing. Not the one. I sure didn't put something inside.
Nope. If you open it, you'll see the soap. What is that?
Okay, I think it's your white soap. Okay. See now, that one.
Lazy.
Speak for yourself. So.
Your brain. It is
There's still a little of Harry left. Kunle dutifully prepares the snack, and again Edmund, the tribe leader, helps. Have we not already gone over this?
I beg you, don't put those ones, don't put those ones. Even these ones, sir.
Hey!
Only salt, though. I swear, ghost meat and the bomb. Ah! And this kind of thing where your brother they call, who walk by me? Oi! Ah, this is only your baby's thing, man.
Ifunanya doesn't eat goat, so she picks some palm kernels alongside Bobby, who shares her philosophy on jungle cuisine.
Leader of life.
Don't scare
me. Yeah, no. The best leader, don't worry.
In a moment, the place of the talking drum, the downpour edition.
What are you not saying? Can I go 4 days without food now? What is how much time? Chidi bad mercy on you. They are giving like 3 days, 72 hours.
Feels empty, right? Yes, I wish there were more people so that you could feel warmer.
Yes, sir.
The fact that you are here under the rain should tell you how seriously the Council of Elders wish to communicate their disappointment with the recent events. This is the Hammer Tribe. What did I say?
This is the Hammer Tribe.
What did I say?
This is the Hammer Tribe.
Do you know the difference between the Hammer Tribe and the two tribes that were before? Edmund?
These are the strongest of warriors between the two tribes.
Yes, what else? Ifunanya?
Warriors in search of the ten symbol.
Say again?
The warriors in search of the ten symbol.
Dennis? Okay.
The chosen warriors to find the ten symbol.
Bobby.
Well, the selected few that will continue on the quest in search of the ten symbol.
Tracy. As
the above said, sir. Just as the above said, sir.
Three of you, take a look here. You, take a look there. So all of these things that you have just said to me now, this is the jungle. This is a battle between you and nature. There's only one objective, finding the tenth symbol, the only reason why we're here. The merriment, the challenges, the games, the friendship, the bitterness, the bruises will all fall by the wayside. We are only interested in one thing. That person who will find the tenth symbol, retrieve it, and hand it back to the Council of Elders. That's all we want. We expect that each and every one of you will be sleeping, eating, breathing, and dreaming only that one objective. You were out here in the rain because it is important that you understand that we remind you of the reasons why you are here. Take a look, there are six of you. By the end of this search, you will wish that you started today to put in place the things that I'm saying to you now. By the end of this search, five of you sitting here will be saying, I did my best. I gave it my all. Only one person will be saying, I came, I saw, and say again.
I conquered.
Only one person will be able to say that. Each and every one of you can be that one person. I need to remind you, that's why you're here. That's what the council saw. That's why you were chosen to come into this place. You have lost six people. We do not mind sacrificing five more. We know that one of you will bring home the treasure that we seek. Go home and think about what I've just said.
Thank you, sir. Thanks.
And there you have it. Sometimes we do not discover our greatest strengths until we are confronted by our greatest weaknesses. The entry continues. This is still the Gulda Ultimate Search 10. My name is Chidi Mokuma. See you tomorrow. Good night.